In the rolling hills of Tairawhiti lies Piritaha Station.
1,200 acres. We run sheep and beef.
Brett's been at the helm for years, but it's time to let go.
Joe's really the boss now, I'm only the boy.
So he's been stepping into new shoes, literally. Only they weren't up to the job.
Brett, how have these boots been doing?
No good. Had problems with the soles.
Yeah, in what way?
The soles seem to decompose.
Can you show me? All right, so like I could actually... Oh, is that your foot?
Just about. Goes right through, but...
He expected a bit more wear and tear for the $300 or so, especially from a name he thought he could trust.
Yeah, Blundstone is a well-known brand, but they're not really suitable for New Zealand sheep farmers' work.
Have you seen their video?
No, I haven't seen their video.
Okay, so let's take a look at this. I'll show you.
For 150 years, they've been worn by those who never took the easy way.
It suggests their boots are made for more than walking.
History's given you some pretty tough boots to fill. How you fill them, that's up to you.
So how do you like to fill them?
I bought them for sheep, you know, for everyday work on a sheep farm, really.
He's actually still a fan.
I like them because they've got the steel cap and the zip, which when you get a bit older, of course, it's easy to put on.
Those steel caps working wonders against scrambling sheep, but Brett says it's no good having a tough top if what's underneath packs up in less than a year. So he feels...
Bloodstone's not telling the whole truth. They should be worn for casual, not for work. Hello, Bloodstone.
He called Blundstone head office in Tamaki Makaurau, Auckland.
Just ringing up to tell you that my boots that I've purchased from a farming retail shop are not really suitable for farm use.
He says he got nowhere raising the issue where he'd bought them.
They waited for the rep to come back and he had a look at them, but he wasn't interested in talking to me.
And his calls weren't helping either.
Said I shouldn't be wearing them in the sheepyards and to change into gumboots. Well, that's completely impractical because every time I bring some sheep into the yards and have to put in gumboots on, it's a real chore. Well, that's impractical. During the summertime, we're bringing different mobs in and mobs out and drenching and dipping and everything else. If I had to put my gumboots on every time I went into the yards, it'd be like a yo-yo going backwards and forwards, you know, and then get back into the other boots and gumboots are very hot to wear, and I don't really like wearing gumboots in the yards. No, I never got any further. Twice I rang and gave them my number and I thought to myself, well, I really want some response because I bought some boots and I didn't really get the fair go on them.
Your favourite programme?
Yeah. Could be. Well, it might be, I don't know.
It's a good start when Fairgo put Brett's concerns to Blundstone. They stepped up, asking to inspect the boots before giving a response. But although they were sent over a week ago, they still haven't arrived.
As we are yet to receive the returned product for testing, it is not possible for us to give a comprehensive answer at this time, but we wish to assure the consumer that we are taking his concerns seriously and will test and review the product once it arrives.
So, are Brett's style of boots fit for the sheep paddocks, like these boots in Blundstone ads, or are they better off on the catwalk? Blundstone front-footed the issue, promising to send Brett a replacement pair. And until he hears the testing results...
What would you be confident wearing them for?
Just casual.
So you could wear them out for dinner?
Yeah, I could wear them out for dinner, yeah.